a compilation album out from Psychedelic Verse. Well, we can see it in the slide store. Can we, Tony? Tony is there. Here it is. It's called All of This and Nothing. And it has all old songs on it and also a new one, which is All That Money Wants. We're going to see that video next. First of all, we're going to talk a bit about the album. Can you give me, in short, in a couple of words, a little comment on each song on the album, which is from different periods of the Verse's career?
I'll try.
First one is President Gas.
President Gas, I don't know. That's I think it's a good song to start out with, especially in America. It's like an election year.
Uh-huh,
and when we actually wrote the song, it was an election year over here as well. I think it's probably my favourite of the songs we did with Todd Rundgren, who did that Forever Now album. All That Money Wants.
That's the new one?
That's the new song we did with Stephen Street, who's worked with the Smiths. And
yeah, Morrissey.
He worked with Morrissey recently. I like it. It's kind of like a bit of a return to the old sound of the band that we had. It's more layered. It's kind of a bit more mysterious lyrically.
Yeah. Which you are going back to. You told that to Ray already. You need that abstraction around music?
Yeah. Oh, I do. When I've tried to be simple, I think when I'm writing and sitting on my own shoulder watching what I'm doing too much is when I do write the worst songs. And when I just go with it and don't worry about it too much is when I do the best stuff.
Yeah, you don't need storyboards or anything in a song.
No. If I don't write like that. I like to just sit down and start doing it, and what the song's about will, if it's any good, will, you know, gradually come. Instead of sitting, if you sit down and try and write about something, you're limiting the amount, you know, the words you can use and the ideas you can use, and it ends up kind of still.
Next one. Imitation of Christ.
Imitation of Christ and Sister Europe. I mean, I think they sound pretty good, both going together. They're both from the first album that we did with Steve Lillywhite. They're both very moody songs. Actually, the video for Sister Europe was done by Don Letts.
By Don Letts? Who's now in Big Audio Dynamite.
Yeah, a long time before he joined Big Audio Dynamite.
Yeah. You're going to see it later on, by the way, after the news and all that.
Oh, good.
Yeah. He did a lot of videos before he joined the band, didn't he?
Yeah, he
reggae bands and all that.
I think before he did our one, he'd done London Calling by The Clash. And he did the punk movie.
Yeah.
You know, he did that, the Super 8 thing, the punk movie.
Love My Way.
Love My Way. That's another one from Forever Now. I think that was our first hit single in America. I'm totally drunk on the video. I think at one point you can see me sort of staggering away distance. At one point, how it was done, it was to make it look like I was walking in water or on water. They had like tiles about half an inch under the water, and outside of that, it was about a foot deep. And at one point, I went running to the end of the tiles and I stepped off. And if you kind of like try running in water, your body wants to go fast, but your feet don't. And I had to grab hold of a light, and I nearly pulled this light down into the
water.
And one of the technicians kind of grabbed it and stopped me from doing it. Otherwise, I think, you know, the rest of the band would have probably been dead.
You would sell a lot of records after you. You know, that's always a good marketing step to do.
I think that's why they gave me the drink.
Okay, before we get to the other side, let's see All That Money Wants, which is a new video done by who? Who was the director for this one?
God, I don't know.
It's a very nice video, one of your nicest videos, I think.
Yeah, it was one where we didn't really want to go and make, you know, like we are doing in the music. We wanted to take a step back from it, from being very, very produced, you know. So we told the guy that we were actually rehearsing in upstate in New York, and we just told him to try and work the film around just watching us rehearse and just watching us walk around and not try and make it so we had to stand there smashing guitars like it was in the song and all that kind of business. And they actually talked me into singing around the song for him a couple of times because I didn't even want to do that. But he came to me and said, well, look, we've been filming you, but we've only managed to get about 5 seconds of you so far. And it's like our last day. So would you run through it? So I said, yeah.
Okay, let's see it. It's a new track. It's also available on a little EP, which has live music on the back. We'll talk about it later. And it's also on the compilation album, Psychedelic First and All That Money Wants.